hear the worshipers? Where's all of my praises? I want everybody around the world to put your hands together, because all the praise belongs to God. Here we go.
That's why everybody can't go out and witness, not if you don't have no power. Because there were seven brothers called the seven sons of Sceva. The Bible said their daddy was a Jewish priest. And how many of you know, because your dad is a priest, that don't give you no power? I wish I had somebody here right now. The Bible says they took it upon themselves to call over them vagabond Jews. In other words, them demons went bothering them. Tell your neighbor, you better mind your business if you don't have no power. If you don't have no power, mind your business. The Bible parenthetically, come on, tells us that those demons were not bothering them. They said, well, since our dad a priest, let's go mess with them demons over there. Amen. And so they took it upon themselves to call over the vagabond Jews and had the nerve to say, in the name of Jesus, that I heard the Apostle Paul preaching about, I command you to come out. But the Bible says the demons looked at all seven of them and said, listen, Jesus, we know him. Paul, we know him. But answer me one question. Who are you? How many of you know, baby, if you can't tell that demon why you saved and who saved you and whether or not you got any power, the demon will leave you the same way he left these seven brothers. The Bible said the demon jumped on all seven of them, tore their clothes off, and left them running, wounded, and naked. Tell your neighbor, if you ain't got no power, you better mind your business. We'll tell you about it when we get back. You probably need to stay at home if you ain't got no power. But I came to tell somebody, it's not that you can't have the power. Power has been made available to you. What kind of power? Power to deliver the crack addict. Power to deliver the prostitute. Power to set the judge free. Power to deliver the mayor. Come on, somebody. Ain't nobody exempt. The power is available to everybody. Tell somebody we have the power. Yeah, we got the power. Let me move on for the sake of time. But Jesus told them, you will have power. Here's my big point, which carries us over as I matriculate from Acts chapter 1 to Acts chapter 2. The Bible says in Acts chapter 2, yeah, they got together. Let me tell you why they got together. Because they didn't stumble up on Pentecost. They knew it was Pentecost. See, I came here today knowing it's Pentecost Sunday. Not coming to see if something was going to happen. Jesus told them after that, verse 8, you shall receive power. So guess what? They started looking for him. Somebody say power. Jesus already told them in the first chapter, after this, look, I'm getting ready to go. I'm getting ready to ascend back to heaven. But don't worry, don't trip. The same way you see me leaving, baby, I'm coming again, riding on a cloud, but I'm getting ready to go. But after that, you shall receive power. So they were looking for something to happen. Oh, I feel the Holy Ghost up in here now. In other words, they were looking for something to happen. Amen, somebody. And so it just happened to be Pentecost Sunday. It just happened to be Pentecost Sunday. And how many of you ever thought about just getting together with your neighbor and said, neighbor, won't we get together since it's Pentecost Sunday and just maybe, perhaps, something just might happen? Come on here, somebody. See, they're reminded that Jesus already told them. I came to tell some of you in here, Jesus already told you in his word, I want to save your children. He already told you, amen, you're the head and not the tail, you're the first and not the last. He already told you, Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 2, that I have blessings that will overtake you and run you down. Some stuff, you don't have to even ask God if it's his will. You already know it's his will. How are you going to be married asking God if it's your will, should I go back home? That's your wife. Tell somebody, you know that's his will. Some things we already know, amen, somebody, but we're just not exercising the power, amen, hallelujah. So in Acts chapter 2, they got together, 120 of them got together, 120 of them. My first point, somebody tweet this for me, Pentecost was more than a meeting. Somebody tweet that for me, amen. Pentecost was more than a meeting. If you see all the people on telephone, don't worry about that. As long as they're not talking on them, amen. We embrace technology to get this gospel out. I recognize we're in the last of the last days, and Jesus is soon to return, and I don't have time to be religious. Amen, somebody. Talking about what we should do and should not do. When I was laying up in the hospital, I was appreciating them texts, baby. While my heart was hurting and I had cancer in the middle of my chest, I was so happy to get those texts on Sunday morning when I couldn't come to church. And the same way we're here today, there's somebody in McGuffey's nursing home. There's somebody in Coosa Valley right now. There's somebody in Gaston Healthcare. Somebody is in the county right now. There's somebody in Draper, in Atmore, in West Jefferson, and Limestone, and St. Clair. There's somebody in Kilby right now. There's somebody, come on, in Tutwiler right now. And the only gospel they gonna hear, baby, is from some of us who recognize God has given us the power. Tell your neighbors and neighbor, it's time to use the power. God has given us the power. It's time to use the power. Pentecost, yeah, it was more than a meeting. Economy. It was more than a meeting. When they got together in Acts chapter 2, 120 of them went up. But guess how many came down? Only one. Why? Because when we get together, help me, Holy Ghost, unity is so important for the power of God to move. God can't move where there's division. Come on. The Spirit of God can't operate where there's division. If we want to see the flow of the Spirit, if we want to see the power of the Holy Ghost, you got to forget about who hurt you. You got to quit talking about who let you down. You got to stop reminding your spouse about what they did a year ago, 2 years ago. Baby, you are hindering your blessing. Peter told us, dwell with that girl according to knowledge as the weaker vessel, that your prayers may not be hindered and that you together may be heirs together of the grace of life. Tell your neighbors and neighbor, have I done anything to you? For the sake of the glory, can you let it go? Look at another neighbor and say, neighbor, just in case I offended you, just so it won't hinder the power, can we just let it go? Can we squash it today? Because today is Pentecost, and just in case God wants to move, in case the Holy Spirit wants to heal somebody, in case somebody's marriage about to be set together, in case somebody's child about to be set free from drugs and alcohol, grab your neighbor by the hand and say, neighbor, because today is Pentecost, can we let some stuff go? Can you forgive me for what I've done? Can you forgive me for what I said? That the power of God may flow. Somebody shout, give us the power. Hallelujah. We need the power. I'm giving you some application. If I preach to you, I'm giving you some application. We're not just going to shout and jump and have a good time. No, when you get home, when you sit down, you're going to have some application. If you want the power, you're going to say, oh, I heard the preacher say, baby, you know what? If we just get together, no matter what kind of differences we had before, to get the power, to get the glory, to get his anointing, the only thing we have to do is unify. I want to see this church unify as one man. Come on here, somebody. We got 200 or 300 people in here right now. Guess what? If we get on one accord, 300 came in, but only one can go out. I need somebody here right now to shout Pentecost, Pentecost. Tell somebody we need the power. It's amazing what you can do when you get together. My Bible says one can chase 1,000, but two can chase 10,000. Ecclesiastes says one is good, two is better, but a threefold cord. Good God Almighty. Tell somebody it's not easily broken. A threefold cord is not easily broken. Proverbs said, if one be by himself, he be cold. But if he get together to get another, if he get together with another, he can generate some heat. I came today to generate some heat, baby. I want to see some folk in here today get on fire. Come on, not just be satisfied with just going to church and going through the motions, but get set on fire. And to get set on fire, God have to break you sometime. He have to break my will and break your will. He have to reduce you down to nothing. He have to rob you of some stuff that your flesh want to do in order to see the glory. I want to see the power. Somebody shout, God, give us your power. Hallelujah. Number one, Pentecost was more than just a meeting. Amen, somebody. It was strategic. It was a time of celebration. By the way, Pentecost is also have several other names. It's called the Feast of Weeks. Amen. Because of the 7 weeks, 7 times 7, 49 plus 1. It's also 50, the Feast of Weeks. It's also called the Feast of Harvest. Oh, help me, Holy Ghost. So when we talk about Pentecost, we also talking about the Feast of Weeks and the Feast of Harvest. In other words, there's some of you in here, all that you've been through and all that you've been sowing, baby, you better get yourself ready. All is reaping time for you. I don't know who I'm talking to in here right now, but there's somebody in here right now. You've been wondering, God, how long do I have to wait? How long will it be? Other folks around me getting their breakthrough, getting their blessing. The Lord told me to tell you, though it tarry, wait a minute. Oh, help me, Holy Ghost. Look at the person next to you and say, neighbor, though it tarry, continue to wait on it. Why you want me to wait, preacher? Because they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings that they shall run and not get weary. They shall walk and they shall not faint. Baby, weeping may endure for a night, but tell your neighbor, your joy is about to come in the morning. You've been going through hell all your life. Won't you look at somebody and tell them, good morning, good morning, good morning. Your morning time is coming. Number one, Pentecost was more than just a meeting. Don't think that Pentecost was just a meeting. No, in Israel's day, it was a season. From Easter to now, Pentecost would still be going on. Today, we would be closing out Easter if we were part of the nation of Israel. Come on, somebody. Because Pentecost was a season, amen, somebody, where the Spirit of God moved. Number one, we gotta have unity if we're gonna see the power. The devil don't ever wanna see you unified. If you ever wanna hinder your blessings, it's easy. Just get divided. What they call Jesus Beelzebub, Jesus said, listen guys, that's nonsense. Any house divided against itself cannot stand. So how can you call me the chief of Beelzebub when I'm casting out demons? That's all he was saying. Amen, somebody. Now, what God want to do in your life is going to require unity. Somebody say unity. And how many of you know sometimes, I'm about to get in trouble now, you got to love the unlovable.